Welcome back to Palm Breeze Cafe. Kim, I want to send some email about a meeting I'm having. How do I do that?
I don't think you can, Lee. No, actually, you can. Of course you can.
Of course I can. I'm on exchange.
You can do email about meetings, but we're going to talk about the Gmail system that we're going to be using in Palm Beach County Schools. We've done a couple segments as sort of a casual look early on, so kind of a preview of what's coming. Still in beta and still not a release date.
The nice thing is everybody at home can use this too.
That's correct.
I use Gmail at home all the time.
You can set it up at home and use it on your mobile devices and kind of get used to what you're going to see in your work environment, which is going to be very, very similar to what you see in the free Gmail. So I've got my Gmail up. We're going to actually talk about calendars today because calendars are integrated with email in this Google system.
I love that they put that on the
side there. And you see right from the start, over on the left-hand side of my inbox, I have my little mini calendar showing there, and it's going to show me upcoming events, and if I want to find an event from my calendar or look at the details, it's always on my email, so it's always there.
Okay.
It's always present
to give me
that kind of visual reminder. But the regular email system is accessed through a link at the top left corner of the page above the school district logo. Remember, Lee, everybody can customize the appearance of their Gmail account.
Yeah.
So I've got my beach theme going here. Yours may look
a little
different. But up above the school district logo is going to be the link to the calendar. And I click on that, and it's actually going to open a new page or a new tab, in this case, in my browser. And it's going to show me all the events that I have scheduled for this week.
Okay.
Now, obviously, you can see this. So we're shooting this on Thursday, 10/14, and that's highlighted in yellow to show me that this is the current day. And then I'm showing my week view, and you can see you can change that across the top. There's a series of buttons. So if you want to see today, you can click
full day
on the day, or you want to see the week, which is how I typically have mindset.
And you set that up in the settings, right?
I know. It's automatically that way.
Yeah?
I think by default it goes to week, so I didn't make any changes that way.
But you could change it.
Yeah, you could. You could change your default. We'll take a look at the settings here in a second. If I wanted to see an agenda view, then a list
of all the
events. And that's kind of handy when you can look down and see, you know, sort of a snapshot of all the events and the things that you have scheduled coming out into the future. I've also, by the way, I've got mine turned on for U.S. holidays, and we'll take a look at that. So those are the different ways that you can view your calendar. I'm going to switch back to my week. Now, again, over on the left-hand side in this left column underneath the district logo, you have all this other interesting stuff. One of the things that people are going to find out is how easy it is to create shared calendars. Since everybody on our team, our educational technology team, we're all part of the beta, we've all created calendars and shared them with each other, and we have a team calendar. And what's, again, cool here is if I want to see what's scheduled on our team calendar, all I have to do is click on the name of the calendar.
Okay.
And now my calendar view over on the right changes to show everything. And you remember in Outlook, you'd have to go through a little bit harder process
First, you would have to make sure you had shared with everybody.
Exactly.
And then open up each calendar.
And it's much easier in the Google environment. So if I'm looking to schedule something, let's say I want to schedule something with my coworker Kim Culp, I can come down to his calendar that he shared with me. I can turn that on, and I can see when he's busy and when he's available.
Okay, that's great.
And then I can just turn that off. And I mentioned before the U.S. holidays right here. I have that turned on. So I knew Monday was a Columbus Day and didn't keep me from working, unfortunately.
No,
but good idea to have those holidays at least.
Yeah, because you can't go to the bank.
That's right.
What happened to Wednesday?
Wednesday? What about it? There was nothing on Wednesday. I had nothing
Wednesday,
scheduled.
You were probably working in your office.
I was in my
office.
No
appointments.
I had no appointments that day. So I was working in the office and doing that kind of stuff, keeping people out of trouble. All right, so now I'm in my calendar, and then there again, like with the with mail, there are a lot of settings that you can choose. So when I click on settings, upper right-hand corner, there are two kinds of settings. There's a setting that only applies to my calendar, which is what we'll look at now, and then there are settings for my entire account.
You do realize that mathematically you're not going to have time to go through the settings.
I understand that, but I want to take a quick look at it here. And these are all the default settings, the general basic settings. In most cases, you probably won't change any of these. What I like, though, and again, calendars, these are all the calendars that have been shared with me that I have access to, and I can change the way that I interact with them. But here's the one I love, the labs.
Yeah, I saw the beaker in the upper right.
Because Google makes things so much fun. And you can do all sorts of really cool things. So you can add extra emoticons. You can change the way that you're reminded about an upcoming event. Okay. Maybe you don't want that yellow flashing thing.
Now, next
so
week, you
all
can probably
sorts
show us
of things
a bunch of
in Google Labs. And maybe we'll do one more, or maybe we'll just keep on doing Google.
Yeah.
But lots of cool stuff that's right in your settings. And again, what's nice about the Google environment is you can customize it to suit your work habits and the way you like it.
Great product. We're going to see you next week on Palm Breeze Cafe, so
come
make sure you join us.